Hello, everyone. It's of course September the 11th, this is the. Well, usually when I start this show every night, I say it's a great day for America, and I of course in September the 11th, I every year I think to myself, you know what? It's not my job to deal with this on TV. I'll just I'll let it go and I'll just say it's a great day for America. And every year, run about this time at the start of the show, I think no. You've got to mark this spot, but. I tell you what I do think. I do think it's a great day for America. I think what happened to us, how long ago is it now? 8 years? 9 years? 8 years? It's 8 years now, isn't it? What happened 8 years ago? It's such a terrible assault, such an awful shock, such a world-changing moment. And of course it sent us reeling, and then it started off a whole chain of events, and I was the event in itself was cataclysmic, but we're still here, and we're better than ever, and we're going to be here, and I know that this this show goes out on the internet and computers and people pirate it and I can't think for the life of me why they do this, but this happens. So there, it's conceivable that even people who do not like the United States of America will see this show. Who people who are not our friends may be able to see this show. So if you are watching, first of all, and then. Please. I'm preparing a speech for the United Nations. And also... and secondly, you should probably be in possession of some information. We're not going anywhere. We're not going anywhere. Not now, not then, not in the future. We're not going anywhere. We're here. We are the United States of America. We are more than a country. We are a dream. And we're not going anywhere. We'll be right back. Oh boy, no, please keep. No! Oh gosh, no, come on now, everybody. I'd like to thank the Academy. Hi. Hey, you know what? I'm very excited. As you can tell. I'm very excited because, of course, it's Friday, everybody! Yeah! Yes, it is! There's a movie opening today. There's a movie opening today called Whiteout. I'm very excited about this. Whiteout, this movie. Finally, a movie about liquid paper. In a world where people make mistakes. There's a fluid that covers them up. Do people still use Whiteout? I don't know. Nobody writes on paper anymore. You're writing on the computer. I still use Whiteout, though. I go through 5 computer screens a week. Don't. It wasn't funny. I knew it wasn't funny before I said it. But I said it anyway, and do you know why? Because I'm optimistic, that's why. Do you know who invented whiteout, by the way? The mother of Mike Nesmith, who was the guitar player in the Monkees.
I know!
And that's why Mike Nesmith didn't participate in any of the Monkees reunion shows, because he didn't need to. He's like, screw you guys, I'm heir to the whiteout fortune, I don't need you! But, of course, the glory days of correctional fluid are over now. The money will be drying up. Yeah. Next year, he'll be putting on the little monkey suit and the little woolly hat. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. He'll be out there. Now, and I can't wait. I love me the Monkees. Do you know what the movie Whiteout isn't about Whiteout? It's about a US deputy marshal who investigates a murder in Antarctica. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, well, Craig, who is in this movie? You know, because who do you think is in the movie? When you think grizzled, crime-solving American deputy marshal, who's the first person that comes to mind? Take a look. Yes. Actually, that's often the first thing that comes to mind for me, no matter what I'm thinking about. Actually, Kate Beckinsale in the movie. You're going to see a person, wow, that's a very attractive young lady. Now, this shows you how much times have changed. Because 20 years ago, a US deputy marshal had been somebody like Tommy Lee Jones or something like that. These days, if you want a US deputy marshal in your movie, you use a sultry British lady. It's the same with late-night talk show hosts. It used to be cranky middle-aged guys from the Midwest. Now they use a sultry British lady. Good evening. I'm actually okay with Kate Beckinsale playing a sexy US Marshal, but what I don't get is the idea of setting the movie in Antarctica with Kate Beckinsale in it. She's going to have to wear a lot of clothing. It's very cold! Although somehow I think they'll find a way to get her undressed in the movie. Oh, I've been trudging through the snow all day. Oh, I'm so snowy out there. I have to just... Do you guys have a hot tub? I just take off my jacket and my other jacket, my flannel shirt and my... Oh, yes, I always wear lingerie under my parka. Although Antarctica sounds like a fascinating place to me. I wouldn't want to go, though. I like a bit of solitude, but Antarctica, I mean, come on. That's a little too extreme. Cold, dry, windy. Remind you of anyone? If you don't know where Antarctica is, well, it ain't Australia and it ain't Africa. So it's kind of the world's undercarriage. I can't say what I was going to say. You know what I was going to say. Even though Antarctica is very cold, it's actually the world's largest barren desert. The world's second most barren desert is NBC's primetime schedule. Oh, yeah, make me the bad guy. Yeah, make me the bad... I'm the one who did it. I'm the one who says, yeah, we'll take that thing that's really working there and put it over there and then move that thing over there and then... Oh, I'm the one who did that. I think I'd be better and safer talking about Antarctica, don't you? You know, scientists say that 98% of Antarctica is covered by ice. And they say that's exactly the same percentage as Dick Cheney's heart. See, if you go to Antarctica, there's not much to do. There's no roads, no stores, a couple of Starbucks. A Kentucky Fried Penguin, that's it. It's the only continent in the world, Antarctica, with no permanent residents. The people who are there temporarily to work at research stations. No one wants to stay there too long. You know, people go there, they stay a couple of months, and they leave again. It's kind of like... It's kind of like Jennifer Aniston's bedroom. People go there for a couple of months. Say things that are true, Craig. Oh, yeah! I mean, no disrespect. I'm just a panicky vaudevillian in the middle of the night. you know what else is down there? Penguins. In Antarctica. Not Jennifer Aniston's bedroom. There might be penguins there. I've never been. Maybe that's what the problem is. Like, I love you, Jen, but the penguins, I can't deal with the penguins. I won't give up my penguins. Then I'm leaving. Angelina doesn't have penguins. Oh, yeah, make me the bad guy. That's right. All right, all right. I admit, that was too far. Wasn't that too far? That was too far. I'm sorry. I'm a douchebag, everybody. I'm sorry. My apologies to everybody involved. Look, I don't like penguins anyway. Yeah, I can say, oh, there's going to be a lot of letters now for the, oh, how dare you, Craig, penguins are adorable. No, they're not. They're just cold pigeons. Do you know when I grew up, there was a zoo near my house? Well, not that near. Quite near my house. I mean, you had to drive. Look, it doesn't matter. That's not the important part. It wasn't like I lived next to a zoo growing up. Craig, you seem to know a lot about animals. Yes, I lived next to a zoo growing up. I did. I'd be lying if I said that. I was nowhere near the zoo. Look, you know what? I actually lived about 500 miles from the nearest zoo. However, there is a zoo in Scotland called Edinburgh Zoo, and it's in the town of Edinburgh. And every... I know. Every day at 1 o'clock, they have the penguin parade, and they have these penguins, and they let them out, and they walk up and down the the zoo area. And every day, about just about 10 minutes after they start walking out, some kid gets their eyes picked out by a penguin. It happened to me. I had to have my eyes replaced with bionic eyes that can now see through televisions. Nah, I've got regular eyes. Get a bit droopy, actually, in my eyes. Amongst other things. We'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody.
And now, celebrities read excerpts from Craig's book.
Robbie and I took a few tabs of acid on Saturday night. We were heading home across the gothic expanse of Kelvin Grove Park just as the acid began to kick in. Robbie, for some reason, kept turning into Adam Ant. I asked him to stop, but he said he couldn't help it. So I shrieked like a wee girl and ran away from him.
That was Celebrities Read Excerpts from Craig's book. American on Purpose is available September 22nd from all Finer bookstores. If you experience an erection lasting longer than 4 hours, please call a doctor or Craig Ferguson.
I'm practicing in case I get a band. Do we have time for emails tonight? No. Then why are you holding them? All right, then. This is from Scott in Huntington Beach, California. What's funny about that? Scott says, Craig, are you a better pilot or a late-night talk show host? Think of myself as a late-night talk show host. I really don't. I mean, I know that CBS puts this show on late at night, but that's only because they're embarrassed. It's not because I'm a late-night talk show. Late-night talk show hosts are clever and cool and can do things. I'm none of those things. I'm panicky. That's kind of my thing. Oh, no. Oh God, this is very long. If you're sending an email to the show, try and keep it short, and I'll tell you why. Because I've got what do they call it? The attention, ADD. The ADD. Is that a real thing, or is that a real thing? ADD. Is it? Is that a real thing? I guess it is. I don't know. Oh, look, that cup's nice. I don't know if I really believe in it. Yeah! This is from Arthur in Garland, Texas. Arthur must be a tough name to have in Texas. Like, if people say Tex and Billy Bob and, you know, Mitch. Yeah, Mitch, that's a good name. What's your name? I'm Mitch, I'm out of Abilene. What's your name? Arthur. Arthur says, hello, Craig. I wanted to know what you wanted to be when you were a kid, and are you disappointed with how your career turned out? Well, the first question is, I wanted to be an astronaut when I was a kid, and I think that answers the second question. This is from Billy in Kirkwood, Missouri. Billy says, do you ever feel lonely during the show? Often. Usually just as I'm coming to the end of what I thought was a joke. As I roll towards the end of what I was saying, I think, oh, here comes the joke, and then I finish what I'm saying, and I go, oh, it's not a joke, it's in fact a sentence. And I'm actually just talking to myself. All right, this is from Jacqueline in St. Paul, Minnesota, which is near Minneapolis. It's, in fact, right next to it. Yeah, it's like you just go across. It's Minneapolis, St. Paul. They call them the Twin Cities. And you know why? Because it's Cockney rhyming slang. They do. That's Cockney rhyming slang for ladies' breasts. They say, ooh, look at that. Lovely pair of Twin Cities on that girl. They say that. They do. I think we all learned something. Jacqueline says, dear Craig, I need your help. I have upset my best friend. Uh-oh. I promised her I would come over and play cards with her, but instead I went to a strip club with another friend. Now she won't speak to me. Any suggestions? Yes. There's only one way to solve something like this, Jacqueline. Underpants pillow fight. And you'll need a referee. Someone impartial. Someone, perhaps, who's not originally from the United States of America. Man, I'm really creepy tonight, aren't I? Good old. All right, we'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. Thanks for staying with us through these entertaining commercial moments. Why can't I just say what I meant to say? Because you've got ADD. Now, a lot of people don't know this, but Prince Charles is not only the Prince of Wales, but he's also the king of late-night television in the UK. Take a look at this clip from Prince Charles's late-night show. Take a look at this.
Live from Buckingham Palace, it's The Rather Late Programme with Prince Charles. Brought to you by Meat Pie. It's like regular pie, only awful. Ladies and gentlemen, the King of Late Night.
Do we have time for a parchment? Oh, thanks. I thought we'd never get to this bit. All right, This is from Jay in Burbank, California. Jay writes, I just read it. Very clever, yeah. Jay says, dear Prince Charles, I am an American late night talk show host. My network is betting I can save them from ruin by putting me on in prime time. Should I trust them? Well, Jay, you sound like a smart guy, but the people running your network seem to be like a bunch of blithering idiots.
I suppose that's why they work in television. What I'm saying is, for a guy with your talent, being anywhere but 11:30 is like being a prince in the UK. It's comfortable, but the fun can't really start until some old queen dies. So good luck, Jack. Anyway, now it's time for stupid peasant tricks.
Stupid peasant tricks.
All right, bring out the peasant then. Yes, you seem peasanty. What's your trick?
All right, Governor, I'm going to do a magic trick. Please, hand me your wallet.
I'm sorry, I don't really understand what you're saying. I think it was something about hand me your wallet.
That's right.
All right, then. I didn't realise that you were Cockney.
Now you watch.
Well, watch, right. Well, this is going to be hilarious. Just like some kind of David Blaine thing.
And your jewel-encrusted scepter.
All right, it's over here. Hold on. Excuse me.
Now, I'm going to make all this stuff disappear. All right, then.
Well, that was dramatic. Can the Emmy be far away? Yeah. So, petty thievery is your game, is it? I'm very disappointed. You've got to work on a grander scale, dear boy. That's why my car...
Ooh la la!
I'm done. Good night, everyone! To the big show where I'm here, all with all my friends from TV, some puppets, just like my house. My first guest tonight is, in fact, a friend of mine. He is the host of The Price Is Right, which the new season premieres September the 21st. Take a look at this.
Actual retail price: $1,390. Emily.
Pass out.
Oh, Emily's excited. She's gonna pass out. Wow. Emily, you're gonna make me pass out.
Please welcome my buddy Drew Carey, everybody.
I forgot all about Emily.
What?
I forgot all about Emily.
You did not forget about Emily, did you?
I forgot, yeah.
No, she seemed very nice. Did she win when she was on the show?
I have no idea.
You don't remember doing the show?
I do, but I can't remember if she in particular. I forget everybody right away after they've been on. Not in a bad way. I just forget whether they won or lost, like after the show's over. I don't know.
The same here. I don't remember anyone. In fact, so you've got a new movie out or something?
Yeah, yeah. I play a detective in Antarctica.
You'd be good at that. You'd be good at that.
Yeah, because me, you want to cover up in a parka. No. I would look natural covered up in a parka.
I've seen you in a parka. It's kind of a sexy thing.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah. And then Antarctica, I can get away with wearing lingerie.
Why don't you do more movies? I'd like to see you in some
movies. I haven't
done
any movies.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean.
I don't do more.
Why don't you do more than zero movies?
I had two lines in Coneheads.
Oh, I liked that movie. What were you in that movie?
Yeah, I was Man in Cab. Yeah, I was in it. And
that's
Ellen,
the funniest part of that movie, actually.
And Ellen DeGeneres was also in it as the woman swim coach. And she had three lines, I think.
What, really?
Yeah, she
Who
was
Who would have cast Ellen DeGeneres as a woman swim coach?
I have no idea. But anyway,
look at us now. Yeah, yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. What'd you got there, then?
Oh,
you got
I got a big news. I got named on the bid committee for the World Cup committee to get the World Cup come to the United States.
World Cup of soccer?
Yeah.
Oh, all right, yeah. Yes. Congratulations. Well done.
And I'm now I'm now part of the bid committee to try to get it to come here in 2018 or 2022. So they sent me these bumper stickers. See that right there? Can you see that?
Yeah, no, they can't.
There you go.
We only have one camera.
GoUSABid.com. And they're having a contest to see, and I'm going to, and they even gave me a jersey, but it's my name on the back, so I can't really give it to you.
But no, people would want that. You're the new Shaq.
Yeah. It's pretty exciting. They're having a contest to see the whoever puts the sticker in the most original public place. So.
I think the T-shirt's mine, buddy. Yeah. The trouble about this thing is you can't get the sticky thing off the back.
Yeah, you can.
There you go. I'll do it.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah.
It's unstuck already. There you go. How about that?
Yeah.
That's a winner right there. Huh?
Yeah.
Huh? Did we win?
Yeah.
There. All right.
Yeah.
Jeez, it's coming upwards of
40 people will see that there.
2018, 2022. It's so far in the committee, I think it's me, Henry Kissinger, and Landon Donovan.
I had a dream like that once.
Yeah.
Yeah, how are you doing? Are you still enjoying The Price is Right? It's fun down there. I love it.
Yes. Craig's on the premiere show. We have September 21st.
Did
Craig's
I win?
On the show.
I can't remember.
No, but you helped out. You gave away a trip to Scotland.
I did. Yeah. That's good. That means I don't have to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really fun. I like it. You know, the only thing, though, somebody came to me once and did a survey. They did a survey. The three most popular prizes are cars, trips, and cash.
Who would have thought?
Yeah. And I'm like, you got to do a survey? Because I'm standing right next to him, and when Rich Fields ever goes, it's a bedroom set, they always go,
ooh la la!
Yeah.
Ooh la la!
Out of here. Like, they didn't want to... They didn't want to see the guy. Like, they want to kill Yodely guy. They want to make him go over the end if it's a bedroom set.
I liked it down there. I had a good time. I wished you'd
That's a good vibe, isn't it?
I wish you'd let me play the Plinko.
I don't think we were playing Plinko that day.
Yeah.
We did play Plinko because it was the season premiere.
Yeah. You played Plinko. I didn't get to play Plinko.
They didn't let you go up the stairs to play Plinko?
No, they didn't.
Oh.
Well, maybe the next time I come down, you can...
Anytime you want, I'll send you a text next time we have Plinko set up, and you can come down and drop a couple chips down
send
there.
Send me a text?
Yeah. You know, you're into all that stuff. I'll send you
LOL,
a text.
LOL, smiley face. Yeah. That's cool. Yeah. All right. Yeah. How are you doing? What else are you doing? You've been out. You're doing the soccer. Are you been around the country? Are you doing any USO or anything?
I did a gig in Vegas, and I did an improv gig in Vegas with Ryan Stiles and all those guys.
No, the improv gigs you do with the guys. Do you guys really just go out with nothing at all?
Well, we have the game. We know what games we're going to do,
right?
And who's going to be in each game. But then everything we make it up with suggestions from the audience. Every show, like if you ever see us perform in Vegas or something, we usually perform Super Bowl weekend.
Yeah.
At the MGM. So when you come see us, you can come see every single show we do that weekend and never see the same show twice.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really fun. Yeah. It's just like this. You never see the same show twice.
This is completely scripted.
Yeah, but you don't. Yeah, but you don't repeat it. We don't do any. The only scripted part is my stand-up at the beginning.
You think I don't repeat anything? Do we have a picture of Paul McCartney? Do we have a picture of Paul McCartney? We've done that.
Remind you of anyone?
We've done that like 500 times, and I asked for a picture of Paul McCartney, and they put up the
That's
wrong
called...
one.
That's called a callback.
A callback. There you
That's
are.
Okay. Yeah. That's not repeating. That's a callback.
Do you miss doing the stand-up? Just going to the clubs?
Yeah,
and
I do. It was really fun doing stand-up in Vegas. I had a really good time with it. And I
saw you do a comedy club. Where was it? It was in Cleveland. When we were in Cleveland. With the improv in Cleveland.
Yeah, we
Is
were
that still
up there?
There?
Yeah, as far as I know.
I mean, Cleveland.
Yeah. Yeah, as far as I know.
Come on. Do you go back a lot?
Not as much as I want to. It's a real shame. Like I bought the house I grew up in. That's there.
Yeah.
And the closest I got this summer was Michigan. I never really got back the whole way.
What? Why? You got money, buddy. You could have got the whole way.
Yeah, it's the time I don't have. Because I have, I'm doing the show. Plus, I go to the soccer games. I own part of a team. By the way, the Seattle Sounders, part of the team I own part of, I won a championship last week.
Oh, congratulations. Yeah. There you are. Finally, a return on the investment.
Yeah.
Finally.
It's the U.S. Open Cup. It's a U.S. Open Cup, so it's kind of like a daytime Emmy. Nobody really cares about it unless you win it.
Right,
but it's still something.
Yeah, it's a star.
We won a trophy, that's the main
thing. What about Beckham? Is he at your team yet?
No. He's we don't need Beckham to win.
But the thing to do with Beckham is what you should do is pay him a huge sum of money and then have him break something as he arrives at your club, and then people will get mad at you because he never plays the damn game.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it?
Unbelievable. What, you get $80 million for that?
Well, he can potentially make $50 million a year if the T-shirt sales and everything go right.
Right.
You know,
I think we could all potentially make $50 million a year
exactly.
if the T-shirt sales
exactly.
go right.
That's you and me, pal.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, selling one Cheeky Monkey T-shirt ain't going to make you a millionaire. Hey, you know what we should do?
What?
We should have a Drew Carey Show reunion.
Yeah, we should, shouldn't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, I think we should. I think it's time.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's time.
Yeah. Well, we could reenact our favorite scene from the show.
Oh, I like... Do you remember the scene where you were eating the chocolate and I was trying to make you laugh?
No,
I was trying... No, I know what it was. You were trying to be on a diet and Mr. Weck was trying to make you eat chocolate by showing you how delicious chocolate was. It was one of the first scenes
oh,
I did.
Melty.
Yeah, yeah. And you pretend to be eating chocolate and I'll be Mr. Weck.
Kelly?
Yes?
Oh, no, I'm eating the chocolate. You're trying to not eat the chocolate.
All right.
All right, then.
Mmm, Kelly.
I'm typing. I'm working.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, type. Shut up, Mimi.
Kelly, this chocolate's delicious. Mmm, melty.
I remember that.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah.
Good times.
Melty.
Yeah. Melty, yeah. We gotta go. We're out of time.
I liked when we got married, too.
Yeah, that was good, wasn't it? Yeah, that was ahead of its time.
Yeah.
Yeah. We should put that on the show.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean when we get married on the show?
Yeah.
No, that was good, too.
Oh, are we out of time?
Yeah, we're out of time. Yeah.
All right. Well, that fizzled out really good, that interview.
That was the best interview I've ever seen. Do we have a picture of somebody? There you go. All right. Good carry, everybody. We gotta go. Guest is an actress and a writer. She's on The Office, which premieres on September the 17th on NBC. But it's a very good show, actually, to be fair. Take a look at this.
Eva Longoria needs to be on Desperate Housewives more. I feel like they won't let her act because she's hot, and it's just not fair.
God, I have to get a TV.
Mm. Kelly, shouldn't you be working?
I am working. Fine, Michael, fine.
She's sweet.
Please welcome Mindy Kaling, everybody. Mindy Kaling. Welcome, Mindy. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you for having me back.
It's very nice to see you again. I'm always very happy to see you. And the last time you were here, you said you were going to Las Vegas, and I recommended Lovett's frozen custard. And did you go?
I did go.
It's good, right?
It is good frozen custard.
There you are.
I'm a little mad at you, I have to say. Because I went to Lovett's... I'm sorry, I hate to start off with this, but you brought it up, so I have to...
Okay.
I was going to celebrate my 30th birthday, and
no
I went
way.
With my...
No way!
Thank you.
All right.
And I went with my best friends. We brought sparkly dresses and heels. Like, we couldn't wear sneakers the whole time.
Awesome.
Yeah, we're going to party and drink. And I came on the show, and you were like, oh, you got to go to Lovett's frozen custard.
Yeah.
And I told my friends, I was like, Craig Ferguson told me this. This is a big deal. And
Mr.
he's a
Vegas.
Celebrity. Yeah,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
So we went to this frozen custard place in, I believe, the most dangerous and sketchiest neighborhood I've ever been to in my entire life. It's so insulting. Like, we were in our little dresses. And I was like, guys, this is going to be awesome because that guy told me. And they're all excited. Went to the parking lot. First of all, there's like... This is true. Like, there was a homeless man walking across the parking lot with a T-shirt on and then, like, no pants and no underwear. And he just, like, waved.
I'm trying to get to the part that's not good about this.
I'm I just, and you know, you go to Vegas and you have these ideas, like, oh, it's gonna be like Ocean's 11, I'll get married to a stranger, I don't know, like, this great romantic thing could happen. So we go there, the custard is good, we're disconcerted because there's a naked man across the parking lot. And this is why I knew it was really a bad place. There's a pickup truck there, and two seedy-looking guys come out of the pickup truck and come over to me and my, like, group of friends, and they're like, hey. We were like, oh, hey. And he's like, hey, we love The Office. I was like, oh, great, thank you. Not murderers.
Right. Because murderers don't watch The Office.
And they're like, yeah, you know, we actually have a better car than this pickup truck, but we're in an undercover drug sting to the place next to the frozen custard place. This was like an area rife with drug dealers and drug addicts. And then me and my defenseless friends.
Was the custard good?
And you know the worst thing is they were like, there is no way that Craig Ferguson told you to go here. Like, they took your side. As though, like, I was like, no, I swear. So.
Was the custard good?
Okay, yes, the custard was delicious.
Was it worth risking your life for?
I guess in a way.
You're right, exactly. Now, because when you were going up to Vegas, when you were here last time, you were going on a girls' weekend,
mm-hmm.
And because your boyfriend was going on, you were wondering about whether you should invite your boyfriend.
No. Can I interrupt you for a second?
Sure. Yeah.
My boyfriend was just going to have a nice weekend in LA and just miss me and think about me and things like that. And then you were like, oh no, he should go to Bangkok and meet prostitutes. He really said this. He's like, why shouldn't he get some?
That?
Yes, you alluded to that. If you can find the footage, and this is what he said you should do.
Really?
Yeah, you...
God, what a jackass I am. Did he go to Bangkok and meet prostitutes?
And you know, he's such a good guy that he didn't take your advice.
Ah, great.
For so as what long did, as I know.
Well, no, because you were in Vegas.
Mm-hmm.
Did he go... Well, no, the reason I brought it up is because you said, I don't know if I should invite my boyfriend to the mm-hmm. girls' weekend in Vegas. And I'm like, no, you shouldn't invite him to that. He should have a boys' weekend to do something boy-like.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, maybe go to Bangkok and meet some prostitutes. Or... And what I meant by that is maybe fishing or... Something.
Interview prostitutes for National Geographic.
Right, something like that.
Right.
National Geographic.
Yes.
let me see. Yeah, all right.
And an anthropological trip, just to see.
Yeah, well, you don't have to go as far as Bangkok for that kind of thing. They got that in Vegas, right next to Lovett's Custard, actually. You could have... I'm sorry. Did you have an otherwise nice weekend there?
You know, I think I'm not... suited for Vegas, I think. Like,
yes.
Both of my credit cards. This is a true thing. If you give your credit card at a bar, if you give it to someone, like 90% of the time, they like photocopy the card and then make a new card and then give you back your card. And that happened to both of my credit cards. So I kind of had a bad weekend. I lost a ton of money.
That's Vegas.
Yeah?
Listen, here's what really happened. You met a couple of cool undercover cops. You lost all your money. You mm-hmm. got a couple of good stories to tell.
Mm-hmm.
You had an adventure with your girlfriends wearing heels.
Mm-hmm.
And you had some great custard. What the hell do you want?
No. I think maybe my standards are too high. No, you're right.
I need you to go on a trip for us again. Where are you going to go next time? We're out of time, but I want to send you on another trip. Here's where I'd like you to go next time.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
I've heard there's a really good yogurt stand.
God.
Or yogurt stand. In Baghdad. Could you try that out?
It makes me mad because if you're going to Boston, where I'm from, and you're like, hey, Mindy, where should I go? And I was like, oh, Craig, you got to go to Skid Row. That is where it's at. You'd be so angry with me.
You assume that I've never been. He's the lovely Mindy Kaling, everybody.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
We talked way too long. I can't be wasting any more time with the great CBS network by continuing to talk. All I have to do, this is all they asked me to do. Please say goodnight very quickly and we'll get out of here. And we might be on time. But the trouble is, I've got my ADD. Good night, everybody. Good night.